inner critic is the voice that we get to hear in our heads every now and then, all of us, professional and amateur harpists, whether we are aware of it or not. In today's Coffee Break Harp, I'd like to share with you my ways of dealing with that voice when it gets in the way of my harp playing. Hi there, I'm Zuzanna. I am a harpist and a harp teacher, and I also have my own inner voice who has their own opinion about everything I do, both at the harp and away. And while I do realize we can't really silence that voice, I thought that I would share today with you some of the things that I do to keep this little inner critic manageable. I've got 9 tips to share with you today, and of course you don't have to use every single one of them, but I hope that some of these things will resonate with you, perhaps even inspire you, and all in all, make your journey with the harp happier. Before we dive in, I'd like to say something maybe a little bit controversial about that inner critic. This voice is not always bad, and sometimes it can even be helpful. It can, for example, remind you that you shouldn't play the whole piece through just yet, or maybe that you need to play some of the sections slowly, or it can even motivate you to practice in the first place when you don't quite feel like it. The problems start when this voice makes you feel bad about yourself or about your harp playing, when it doesn't make you feel inspired, and perhaps if it even tells you that the whole thing is not worth the effort and you'd better stop playing altogether. One of the biggest revelations for me when it comes to dealing with the inner critic and the first thing that I'd like to share with you today is realization that I am not my thoughts and also that these thoughts are not facts. They are not absolute truths. And if that sounds a little bit strange to you at first, have a look at the difference between these two sentences. Number one, I haven't made any progress on the harp. Versus, I'm having a thought that I haven't made any progress on the harp. I hope you can feel how these two are very different and how different of a conversation you can have with that inner voice from then on. When you can create a little bit of space between your thoughts and yourself, you can then have a choice of how you react to these thoughts instead of letting them make you feel bad instantly. Journaling is something you may find helpful in gaining some distance from your thoughts and having a look at what kind of things your inner voice is saying. I've been journaling in one way or the other since I was very young, and although this was never something I was doing very regularly or in a very organized way, writing things down is something that I find very helpful. Sometimes it's in a notebook, sometimes just loose pieces of paper or just a few words typed on my phone, but especially when I feel quite bad about something, it helps me see things more clearly and to realize what thoughts are behind the emotions that I'm feeling. You may also find helpful learning to observe your thoughts even without writing them down. Sitting for a few minutes in silence and just breathing while watching your thoughts come and go can help you be more aware of the things that are going on in your head. Some people call it meditation, some call it mindfulness, some people use techniques like noting or counting your breaths, but you don't have to do anything special or you even don't have to call it any special names to feel the positive effects of this kind of awareness. If you're not quite sure where to start, there are quite a few books and other resources out there that can help you get started, and I'll put them in the description of this video. One other thing that I find helpful, either combined with the ones that I spoke about before or on its own, is being in nature. Observing how seasons change, hearing the sounds outside, feeling the wind, it's all helping me to gain some distance from these thoughts. If you live somewhere where the season change is really mild or doesn't happen at all, looking at the sky at any time is something worth doing. And also knowing that the sun will set and eventually rise can remind you that whatever is happening, there will be another day and another chance at making things better. So I try to go outside for a short walk every day, but since the pandemic, I've also started growing some plants at home, and even though my gardening skills are rather miserable right now, I find it all very calming. And a lot of this stuff translates pretty well into life and the harp for me. Seeds don't start growing the moment you put them in the ground, but even though you don't see anything changing for a couple of days, it doesn't mean that nothing is happening. So that's something to think about. Being physically active is something that I also find helpful, and it doesn't have to be intense. For example, I often combine being in nature with that short walk if I cannot do anything else, or some gentle stretching at home. For me, the point is to get in touch again with my body, so sometimes I might just change the position, stand up or lie down on the floor for a few minutes to make myself feel more comfortable and to let that body loose up some of that tension. If I have more time to do a little more exercise, I find that getting my heart rate up a little bit while going for a run or doing a bit more intense yoga session makes me feel really, really good. I'm a regular park runner doing my 5K every weekend, and for those of you who don't know what a park run is, I'll put the link in the description, but basically it's a free social event where you walk, jog or run 5 kilometers, usually taking place on a Saturday morning. There are people of all ages and abilities, and you can do it at your own pace. You can volunteer too, so if you're not quite sure about the walking or running part, that's a good chance to take a closer look too. For many of us, the inner voice relies a lot on comparing ourselves to others and telling us whether we're doing better than them or not. This may be more true maybe for professional harpies, but it can affect anyone, and your inner voice usually doesn't take into account things like how many years someone has played or how much time or other resources they have to progress or any of those things that really contribute to differences between us. And what I find that works for me is remembering that the only person it makes sense to compare myself to is me, and when I do this, to look at the skills and experience that I have now that perhaps I didn't have earlier. So maybe the person that I am now doesn't practice as many hours a day as she did in the college, but I'm much more happy with how I'm allowing myself to rest now when I need it. And I am sure that you can find more examples of this in your life for yourself. I don't know about you, but I often find that comparing myself to others often feeds a lot from what I see online and especially on social media. So I thought I would say a few words about how I'm dealing with this, and for me there are a few things. So first, I'm trying to watch closely how following different online content makes me feel, and then I'm allowing myself not to hang out in the online spaces that make me feel a little bit worse. So I'm trying to actively choose what I read and who I follow instead of having all that content meshed up on my feet and scrolling through this big mass of stuff. That's why on my laptop I have added an extension to my browser that blocks the Facebook and YouTube feed, so I don't get to see all that stuff. And because this cannot be blocked in the apps, I have actually removed or stopped using the apps, so I'm not tempted to spend all my time scrolling. And just in case I happen to look somewhere, I've still got time limit, which at the moment is 15 minutes a day, which I think is already a lot when you add up throughout the whole week, and that's how I make sure that I don't get sucked in by that online world. But because social media is made to be very addictive, all those good habits can sometimes stop working, which is why every now and then I still go completely offline for a couple of days and let myself go on a proper social media detox. You certainly don't have to do it all my way. If it all works for you the way it is, that's absolutely fine. Social media and being online is great, and you can find tons of inspiring content. Speaking of which, do make sure you subscribe Coffee Break Harp if you find what I'm sharing here helpful. Also remember that it's up to you to choose and follow things that motivate and inspire you, and that you don't have to follow things that make your inner voice go crazy, even if you think they might be useful at some point. You can find your own ways for that. Talking to someone who's in a similar situation to you can really help, especially if you can both let each other see beyond these tiny bits that we usually share with other people on social media or sometimes even in real life. In one of the previous episodes of the Coffee Break Harp, I talked about practice buddies, also known as harp buddies, and I have given you some ideas about how to reach out and find someone like that. I'll put a link to this episode up here and in the description of this video as well. Last, but certainly not least, since we're discussing talking to someone, I feel like it's important to mention therapy. A good therapist can help you see these thoughts and patterns more clearly, and they can help you realize which of these thoughts are voices from the past, perhaps, that you can't let go of now, and also they can help you find your own, kinder voice. I have started my own therapy in January 2020, which turned out to be pretty good timing given the pandemic and the mess that it brought to everyone's world, not only for musicians. While it can take a while to find a person that you can trust and that you feel safe around, and the whole process is not always easy, I have and I still am finding it very helpful, and I will likely continue for a while. One thing I want to say here is, therapy is something that can help you feel better even if you haven't experienced anything hugely traumatic in your life, and even if your inner voice is only giving you moderately hard time. If you'd like to make most of your time in life or get to know yourself better, it's definitely something worth considering. Now, I'd love to hear from you. How you and your inner voice are getting along when it comes to the heart? What do you do to keep that inner chat manageable, and which of these tips you have tried or will try? Let me know in the comments, and do remember to subscribe Coffee Break Harp if you find what I share inspiring. I look forward to hearing from you and to seeing you here very soon. Take care for now. Bye!